Hey, what's up guys? I am Ghulam Abbas from intoguide.com. In today, I will show you how to install, configure, and upload a theme inside the Xampp here in Windows 10. So let's get started. Before getting started installing and configuring Xampp here in Windows, first you have to download the setup from its site. So go ahead and open up your favorite browser. My favorite browser is Google Chrome, and search there for Xampp. So from here, you have to download the latest version of the Xampp for Windows. You can have a look here that the Xampp is built in according to the 32-bit version of Windows. So here you can have a look here. Here's the version. Just go ahead and here is also this 7.2.6, PHP 7.2.0. So just go ahead and download it on your system. So you can have a look here. If you use it with the IDM, I think it would be better for you. Just go ahead and download that one with the IDM, that will be downloaded faster. So for now, I have already downloaded it in my system and no need for me to download and install it here in Windows 10. So here you can have a look here. The setup is here and it's on the desktop. So double click on it and we have to install the installation process of the Xampp here in Windows 10. So on the user account control, select yes. So it is saying that it is an important notice, but whatever notice it is, just go ahead, select OK, and then start the installation process. On the welcome screen, select next. Also select all the features which needs to be installed with the Xampp, and then click next. And here you have to install the Xampp. Here it should be installed on the drive C and then Xampp, then click next. After that, here you have to uncheck the learn more about Bitnami for Xampp. It's somehow it's giving you information more about it. That's one I'm going to uncheck that one, and then click next. And here you are ready to install the Xampp. So wait until the packages of the Xampp should be unzipped here in Windows 10. Installation will take about 3 to 4 minutes depending on your system. Here the Windows security alert is asking you that do you want to allow the HTTP or whatever it is. Just you have to select all the public network also, and you need to allow the access because the Xampp is using some ports in order to interact with the local server. So later that ports will be available when you actually start the process. So you can have a look here that the installation of the Xampp is now completed, and now you can have a look here. It's saying that do you want to start the control panel now? If you want, just go ahead, uncheck it, and then click finish. So you can have a look here that the Xampp has been installed. You can have a look here that the Xampp control panel. If I have to run it, and then you can have a look here, it is asking from me. You have to configure the language. So I'll select the English language, which is by default selected, and then click save. And now you can have a look here that the control panel of the Xampp will be open for us. So you can have a look here. It is the Xampp control panel version 3.2. So here are all the stuffs available here where you can configure them. So the first thing which we need is I want to create a WordPress site locally, and inside that I also need to test a theme for my site, which is intoguide.com. So first I will go ahead and I will have to download the WordPress itself. So go ahead and open up the Google Chrome and then search there for wordpress.com or WordPress download, it depends on you. Then when it comes, just go ahead and download WordPress on your site. So here you can have a look here, select download WordPress. It is 9.1 MB. It's going to take some time. So WordPress 4.9.6 is now downloaded. If I have to open it inside the folder, and now you can have a look here, that is available here. So the next thing which you have to do is just go ahead and once launch the Xampp and have a look here, is it working or no? So click start and you can have a look here. It is using the port 80 and port 443. And then also start the MySQL, which is the database, which is also required. And it also requires you to enable over the public and the private networks in order to interact with the database. It's also using the default port of 3306. So these are the default ports. So let's go ahead and once search here for localhost. And now you can have a look here. You are inside the localhost of the Xampp. And now it means that the installation has been configured successfully and you won't be facing any problem with it. So you can also click on the phpMyAdmin, which will take you to the databases inside the MySQL. So you can have a look at this. All the it means it is installed. So let's go ahead and start the installation process of WordPress. So the very first thing which you need is to do, just go ahead stop the MySQL and then the Apache. Once you stop them, right click over the WordPress and then extract them here. So once the WordPress is extracted, right click on it and then cut it or copy. It depends on you. I will cut that one and then move to this PC, open the drive C and then open the Xampp folder. Here visit the HD docs folder and open it. And then inside here, you have to create a folder which have to be your site. So I will just go ahead and select a new folder and I will name the site or the database into guide. So I'll paste the WordPress inside it. Or you can have a look here, you can also take them back here. So once it is launched, sorry, once it is copied, just go ahead and start the Apache and MySQL. It's running successfully and also start the Apache. It is on running on the port 3306. So open up and then this time search here localhost. The database name was, I think, what was that one? Into guide. Localhost / WordPress or into guide. Sorry, you have to search localhost / WordPress. Not into guide. So you can have a look here. Here you are in the options of installation wizard of the WordPress inside the Xampp. So you can select your default language and then click let's go. And here you have to select a database. So if I have to tell you exactly about the databases, here by default there are some databases or by default here inside. You can have a look here, schema, MySQL, and all these are by default the default databases. You can create a new one or you can install over each one of them. So I'll just go ahead and I'll simply create a new database, select on the new, and then I'll name it into guide. Select create and the database is now created. You can have a look here. The default, these are the default users. So simply select database name was into guide. I'll paste that one. Username was root. And then there was no password. And then we can have a look at these are the stuffs. And then when you are done, click submit. You can have a look here. You are ready to install the WordPress. Select run the installation. And now you have to name your site. So I'll just go ahead into guide test theme. Type a username. I will simply type here admin, or you have to type any name which you desire, and I'll give a very simple password of pass 123 and then shift 123, and I'll also select confirm use of the weak password, so because it's a testing one. So I type also an email address. I will also type an email address which I am not using, but you can configure it as you wish. So I will not check this one. Yes, I will check this one because it's local site. However, it won't be indexed. And then when you are done, click install and the WordPress will be installed and you will be ready to test out the WordPress inside your local host or in the local server. So done. Here you have created, or sorry, you have installed the WordPress. Select login. So the username was admin and the password was pass123 and then shift123 and then click login and just go ahead, log in and test out the stuffs. So here you can have a look here. You are inside the dashboard of the WordPress. If I have to visit the site, you can have a look here. It is the WordPress theme in 2018. So you can also test whatever you want to do. Just go ahead, create a new post, categories, pages, try out a new themes, plugins, install, or whatever you want to do. You can do them just here. So the very thing which I am looking is testing a theme. So let me, I have to copy the theme and I have to upload that one here. So guys, you can have a look here. I have inserted the USB flash drive of IndoGuide and I'm going to copy these two themes and I'm going to test them out. So I'll just simply copy them on the desktop and you will have a look here how I will upload and if there should be an error, how to solve that error. The biggest problem which I faced during testing this last time, that was the error. I will also tell you how to solve that error. So I'll eject the USB because it will be required for other stuffs for my friends. So let's go ahead and start the uploading of the theme. So open up the WordPress or your local site and then head over to appearance and then select themes. Select add new and then select upload theme. Select choose file. And go ahead and select your file from the desktop. So I'll just go ahead first. I will test out the interactive theme. It is from my theme shop. I think Documentia. I think that's this theme. So select open and now select install. Here you can have a look here. It's saying that the upload file exceeds the upload underscore max file size directive in php.ini. So you have to bring changes in the upload file size in order to upload your theme here. So to do that, this is an error. Just go ahead back and then what you want to do, so stop the Apache and MySQL, both of them. Select MySQL. Sorry, select the Apache and then select php.ini. And then you can have a look here. The php.ini is opened inside the notepad. So the file which was set, I think, max upload. So just go select and edit and then select for their find next and search there for upload underscore maximum or max and then find text. You can have a look here. It has said that upload maximum file size is only 2 MB. More than 2 MB file, you won't be able to upload inside your local site. You can have a look at these are the themes from my theme shop because they are having all the Google fonts. That's why their sizes are 5 MB and then 6 MB. However, the themes is not too heavy. I'll just increase it to 200 MB or even to 200 GB. It depends on you. So select, Control S, save, and then click exit. And now go ahead and start the Apache plus MySQL. So you can have a look at both are running. Just go ahead and open up the WordPress. Again, select upload theme and then select install now. And you can have a look here that the error has been solved, sort out. It means it's solved. So you can have a look here that it has been installed. I'll just simply select activate to activate the theme. Okay. Activate, and it will activate the interactive theme inside WordPress. So it's also telling you that you have to install the plugins. Also, remember you can install plugins here also inside the localhost. Select, apply, and it's going to install the needed. Also, they are not needed, but somehow they are good for you. So ignore the errors, whatever error they are, just simply wait until this installation should be completed. And when you are done, so you can have a look here, it's done. Let me, I have to have a look at the site and how it is looking. Can have a look here, it is the previous theme of intoguide.com. Let me, I have to take you over there, intoguide.com. It is the previous theme which yesterday I changed the theme from the interactive theme to the AdSense theme. So you can have a look at that. The follow us has been also turned on here. Our social media has been loaded from there to in the footer. Just select open YouTube, and as you are watching our video in our channel intoguide.com, so please go ahead. If you like this video, just go ahead and subscribe, because we really need subscribers and we really need to reach the 1000 subscriber as soon as possible. So go ahead. If you like this video, if you like this tutorial, also rate its post inside the intoguide.com. I am posting it right now, and I am also posting it right now currently inside the intoguide channel. So just go ahead and subscribe. So till next time, if you had any question, just let me know under the comment section inside here inside. I have decided that I won't be answering any question after this inside the intoguide channel. So I will be answering them here inside the intoguide.com. So if you had any question, just go ahead, let me know. So till next time, if you had any question, have a nice time. If you had any question, just let me know. So till next time, have a nice time and goodbye.